Thank you. Testing 1, 2, 3. Test, test, test.
Thank you.
welcome to the 2019 BC Catholic Basketball Championships, the 32nd annual Catholics. And we're here for the boys final featuring the Quad A number one ranked Holy Cross Crusaders taking on the number five ranked Vancouver College Fighting Irish. Should be a good tilt.
We're going. This is Kevin Wellsmith, the Lance Hirschbees, coming to you live in Surrey from Holy Cross, bringing you the stream of this game. Welcome you all. Hope you have fun. We've got, this is the fifth year in a row that these two teams have met in the finals of the tournament. Holy Cross taking the last three championships, and BC taking the one before that.
Also their third matchup of the year. Holy Cross winning two so far, including last week at the Legal Beagle tournament at Terry Fox Secondary, where Holy Cross were the champions, and since then have been ranked number one at the Quad A level. We'll see if a couple of important players for Vancouver College are Tony Merrick, who's had an excellent tournament, player of the game from the semifinal game. Luke Terrian, their other big man in the middle, sprained his ankle in the first game of the tournament and did not play in the semifinals, but he seems to be back and good to go. Callum Chow-White had a solid game in the semifinals as well as Hunter Cruz Dumont. And for Holy Cross, Michael Risi was named the player of the game in the other semifinal. Ui Olagola, always spectacular. Brent Padilla had an excellent game from outside in the first half and took it to the hoop in the second half. So some key players for this game.
All right, we're just going to take a break here for a minute for the starting lineups.
Here for the 2019 BC.
Couple notes for this game. Just because of the number of games in this tournament, not a normal format, 8-minute quarters. So it's going to be probably a little more lower scoring game. Teams can go a little bit harder with their subs and their fouls. We'll probably see these starters go a little bit longer than usual.
And BC wins the tip. Heppner over to Callum Chow-White. Back to Heppner. Kell O'Brien looks for the high low to Merrick. Little high, out of bounds, Holy Cross coming back the other way. Full court press by the Irish, man to man.
Usual clash of styles with these two. College usually getting that big size advantage. Holy Cross going with all guards.
Padilla with some contact, no good. Rebound Ogula, tipped by McDonough. And Merrick come back the other way, two on one. One man to beat. Greasy tips it out of bounds. Heppner looking for a foul on the play, no call.
Ball's in quick.
Great defense by Reese there. Ogula gets on it.
Reese coming off the outstanding defensive player of the tournament last week in Terry Fox's Legal Beagle. Holding one of the best scorers in the province, Diego Mafia, to 7 points in the final of that game.
So Holy Cross starts it out 2-0. Andre Mangonin. Chow White with a spin move. Cross-court pass to Cruz Dumont. Chow White for three. Banks it in.
Banks it in. He'll take it.
I don't think he called that. Great defense by Anim there. Ogula gets into the paint. Kicks it over to Padilla in the corner for three. No good. Rebound Merrick.
Usually Padilla's favorite spot, that right corner.
Started the game 3-for-3 from outside yesterday. And Reese called for the block. Trying to draw the charge call on Merrick.
Yeah, leaning over a little bit.
BC will take it on the baseline.
Has his work cut out for him today.
Merrick looks to seal inside. Good defense by Mangonin.
Heppner
tips
really
it out
well.
Of bounds. Good pressure by the Crusaders.
So the biggest thing Holy Cross needs to do here against these bigs is put pressure on the guards. Don't let that ball even get inside in the first place. That's what they're doing there.
Once again, we got a full house here for the final game of the 2019 championship. And him with the crossover guarded tightly by Cruz Dumont. Good backdoor cut by Padilla. Goes up strong. No call.
Merrick just standing tall there.
Great defense by Merrick. Over to Chow White. Guarded by Anim. Full court.
Good discipline by Merrick just to stand there. Let it go.
So we got a 3-2 score here. Vancouver College up 3-2. Kelly O'Brien over to Heppner. High low pass into Merrick. And he fumbles it out of bounds.
So Holy Cross choosing to just full front that in the post. Relying on the help side to come on those lob passes.
Looks like Anim will pick up his first foul of the game. Guarding Cruz Dumont a little too tightly there for the ref's liking. Ball inbounded to Chow White, guarded by Anim. Look right inside, the cross screen.
Double immediately as soon as Merrick gets to the ball.
Over to O'Brien. It's good.
Stays calm in the double team.
And him. Flying up the floor, fouled by O'Brien. Referee is going to talk things over with Merrick and Anim. Getting a little bit testy early in the game. And I'm wondering what the problem is. These teams know each other well. Their third matchup of the year. Ball's inbounded to Reese.
Often playing each other maybe three times a year every year.
Ball over to Heppner. Right back inside. Merrick. And count the bucket. Tony Merrick with the and one. Van College looking inside early and often to Merrick. So that was the second foul on Reese. So that's a bit of a problem for the Crusaders.
That's a huge issue for the Crusaders.
Last year's defensive player of the tournament.
Also a big spark for them offensively, so.
And it looks like a kick ball as Ogula looks to dish it to Mangonin. We've got TJ Fujimura checking in for Michael Reese. Having a seat with two fouls early in the game.
This talented Holy Cross team, also a very young team. They got five grade 11s on the floor. Michael Reese is the only grade 12 starter.
And him looking to inbound it. Gets it into Fujimura. Heppner, a great defense. Oligola in the paint, looking into Mangonin and called for the walk. So Van College, timeout for the Crusaders. Van College playing man-to-man, but doing a lot of switching, it looks like, especially on the guards.
Well, they're ready for that dribble penetration of the Crusaders, trying to get to those spots, the dribble handoffs, this little quick screens. You're going to want to make sure that they're, and then leaving Merich in the post as much as they can just to protect the hoop.
They know that Oligola is going to look to drive from the perimeter, and so they want to collapse in on him. Hopefully, for the Crusaders, if they get that outside shot going, they can get the driving kick happening.
Absolutely.
But Van College is still doing a good job of contesting those outside shots.
Merrick doing a good job also of contesting that shot in there from Oligola, but also keeping a hand out in the passing lane so we can't get that easy pass and that dribble drive down to Mangonin for the layup. Takes up a lot of space in the paint.
So Vancouver College with a 7-2 lead to start the game off. Michael Ricci in foul trouble early. So things are looking up for the Irish.
All right. Vancouver College ball coming in out of bounds. Crusaders picking up full court.
And Van College looking to be victim of the Crusaders' pressure there, trying to bring the ball up the floor with the turnover. Callum Chow-White. And him guarded by Hunter Cruz Dumont. The floater over top, no good. Rebounded by Dumont, Cruz Dumont. But he gets it right back. And looks like we're going to get a foul on Callum Chow-White. So T and him, all effort, the smallest man on the floor. But always gives it his all.
So we've got some subs coming in here for the Irish.
So Sahil Sandhu and Josh Lumtong. Seven in, Chow White and Kelly O'Brien will have a rest.
Pace of this game, the college is going to want to keep it, those guys fresh. Especially they can afford it now that Reese's off the floor.
Padilla across the lane, over to Mangonin, fumbles it. But he's on the floor after it. Picked up by Annan once again.
Too much dribbling in the paint there. It's really crowded.
Step back three. Good.
Really needed that one for the Crusaders.
Crusaders back within two. Annan draws the offensive foul on Sean Heppner. Heppner's looking looking like, what do I need to do to get this guy off of me?
Number six, Sean Heppner, his first.
One of the things Crusaders want to do when they're putting that pressure on, get up in guys' face, frustrate them with the ball.
Intense man-to-man pressure here by the Irish. Ball screen rejected by Anim. Looks to dish to the corner, but it's tipped. We'll stay here. 18 seconds on the shot clock.
A nice look for Holy Cross there, trying to run that high screen and roll. Merrick, knowing that Merrick's going to come out to switch, open up a big lane in the key, getting the big away from the hoop.
Yeah, looking for that weak side help in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Kyle Tejada checks in for the Crusaders. Oligola drives left, back out to the 45. Padilla, three.
He is the sharpshooter on this team.
Lumtong faces some pressure, dishes it over to Sandhu. Great denial defense by Padilla on Lumtong. Skip pass to Cruz Dumont in the lane, over to Heppner for three. Good.
Ooh, answers.
10-8 Van College. Tejada crosses over center, guarded tightly by Heppner. He reaches a little bit over to the corner. Fujimura for three. He's a little short. Rebounded by Merrick.
Rebound, Louie! Rebound!
Just because he misses a shot, Kevin, doesn't mean we have to make fun of how tall he is.
Cruz Dumont back over to Lumtong. Lumtong drives to the middle of the paint. Dishes to Merrick. And one.
That's a tough one for Mangonin. He's just kind of hoping, doing everything he can down there.
And Luke Tarion sprained his ankle in the first game. Still hasn't seen seen any minutes. So they always have a rest for Merrick if he wants it. Michael Chong in for the Irish. Merrick. I almost called him Kukoc. Merrick. Merrick good from the free throw line to convert the and one. Olagola up the floor in a hurry. Little contact, but he finishes. No call.
Nice step around move. Good no call probably. Merrick was just standing, trying to hold his ground.
Cruz Dumont down the lane. And offensive foul called as Padilla slid over in help.
Courageous play there. He took a shot.
So that's Cruz Dumont's first foul. Both teams with four team fouls. So next foul will be shooting bonus free throws. Double team on Olagola. Under his own basket, over to Tejada. Steal by Hunter Cruz Dumont. Over to Sandu. Guarded by Olagola. And he'll get called for the foul.
Ooh. Tough call there. Looks like Olagola had ball.
Foul number 10, Olagola.
Luke Tarion, 6'6", grade 11, subbing in for Merrick.
No lack of depth at the guard or the post position for Vancouver College.
Sahil Sandhu hits the first.
Enough depth, I watched their junior team play. They have a 6'10 and a 6'8 kid playing for their junior team as well.
Not too bad. Anaheim returns to the game for the Crusaders.
Hey, don't guard there! Don't guard there!
Back into the game.
Hunter, where are you forcing it? Where are you forcing it?
Crusaders break the press, and Fujimura attempts the dish, tipped out of bounds by the Irish. Coach Scrub asking his big man in the middle to face the ball on the inbounds play. He's just going to sag in the middle. Over to Fujimura. Lumtong attempts to steal. Olagola comes up with it. Drives middle of the floater. No good. Rebound Fujimura. Olagola right back inside. Over to the corner. Fujimura for three. Good.
Strong play. Two times there for Olagola to get the ball up at the top. Then with the drop ball down low.
Cruz Dumont at the elbow, jumper good, very smooth. Tejada into the paint against Tarion.
Yes,
nice finish.
Nice finish to get that Euro step.
Policarpos warned for delay of game, touching the ball after it goes through the basket. We saw a technical foul given out for that in the semifinal game, so
he's got to leave the ball once it goes through the hoop. Try to protect the advantage of the team that's pressing.
Sandu trapped. Over to Lumtong. Chong right inside to Tarion. He backs in. Pump fake. Short. Gets his own rebound. All kinds of pressure from the Crusaders. Olagola comes up with it. He's coming back without numbers. He's driving anyway. And gets called.
He
gets
two.
The foul call. Fouls on Josh Lumtong. His first personal foul. Both teams with five now, so we're both in the bonus.
Three.
Well, the goal that misses the first. He goes 0 for 2 from the line with the chance to tie it up. Oh.
Violation. He's going to get one more.
So Olagola gets a second chance here. This could bring them within one. Yeah. Second time, good.
Not going to miss three in a row very often for Uwe there, I don't think.
Sandu guarded by Anim. Good cut by Michael Chong. Lob pass to Tyrion in short. Gets no rebound. Misses once again, but he's fouled once again.
That's a Uwe Olagola. That's his second personal. That puts the Crusaders in a really tough spot right now.
And here comes Brent Padilla and Jordan Bantog to sub in for Holy Cross. As the big men on Vancouver College giving them all kinds of trouble down low. Tarrying at the line, shooting two. One for two from the line, rebounded by Padilla. 30 seconds to go in the quarter. Van College up 18-16. Padilla calls for a ball screen from Mangonin. Mangonin rolls. Padilla remains with the ball. Pivots inside over to Tejada for three. Short. Rebounded to Mangonin. Put back no good. Bandog draws the foul on the rebound.
Smart play there to just put it back up. He probably wasn't going to make that one, but drew the contact. Now he's going to line for two.
Good thinking by Mangonin. And Bantog will be shooting two. That foul by Michael Chong is first. Makes good on his first. See if he can tie it up here before the end of the quarter. There's 9.6 seconds remaining. This is the first rebounded by Fujimura. Back out to Bantog. Padilla,
six seconds
to go. Four, three, up.
Oh,
no good. Rebounded by
Tyrion. Got himself a good shot at the buzzer.
So a great first quarter. We got one-point game here. Van College up 18-17.
We've got a ball game. See how this works out. Crusaders with a little bit more the foul trouble with Reese and Olagola right now. See what Coach Pazente, Coach LeChasser can dial up over there, get these guys spare some minutes. I guess they're not going to be sitting the whole second quarter. One of those guys is coming back
in. I was just going to ask, do you think you see Reese and Olagola back in this first half?
Yeah, knowing it's a short game, probably find a matchup they like. Just get those guys on the floor offensively, match up one of those, find the weakest player, maybe a sub in from Bank College and find a place to do that. Maybe dial up a zone.
So prior to this game, we had the girls' final featuring the Little Flower Academy Angels and the number one ranked in AA, St. Thomas Aquinas Fighting Saints, which they won handily. And the girls' tournament champion for the year. So we'll see in a matter of under an hour here who the champion will be on the boys' side.
Looks like we got our starting lineup back out here for Vancouver College.
Fujimura inbounds to Padilla. Ball screen. Great defense by Chow White. And eventually, Padilla did get an edge and will get a foul here on Chow White. I believe that is his second, is it not?
Coach Scrub really upset with that call. Thought that Padilla had an arm hooked around him. He might have. Referee giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player there.
He did a great job of fighting over that ball screen in the first place, but gets called for the foul. Bantog into the paint. Pass fake over to Tejada. Good ball movement by the Crusaders. Bantog for three, no good. Rebounded by Heppner. Chow White.
If there's anybody out there that hasn't really watched the Crusaders play before, pretty much every guy on the team's got a green light from the three-point line. They want to look to run, they want to get to go, and they want to put up a ton of threes.
Kelly O'Brien with the mid-range jumper. Good. We've got a three-point game here. Fujimura, guarded by Heppner. Inside-out dribble, gets it over center. Into the corner and out of bounds. Josh Lumtong returns to the game for the Irish. Chowwhite has a seat with his second foul. And Ennin back for the Crusaders.
T coming back in here to give these guys a little break. He can take handle a lot of the pressure in the backcourt against that college press.
Cross-court pass to Cruz Dumont. Pull up. No good. Great rebound by Merrick. No good. Crusaders all over him, and he'll draw the foul once again. So that seems to be the story. First time miss inside. Offensive rebound. Foul.
That's really the cure to the a lot of pressure there. If you can make that long cross-court pass against that trap, that's the guy that the most pressing teams will leave open. A little more pressure on the ball to prevent that from happening.
Merrick makes the first. Two for two from the line. 5-point game here. Irish leading. Fujimura cuts through the middle, gets the pass. Over to the wing. Back up top, Padilla. He'll take the three. No good. Rebounded by Lum Tong.
Crusaders got to stop this run right now.
Coach Scrub asking to watch the hands and gets the call. And him asking the ref what the foul is for. So that's his second foul.
Yep,
so
two.
Another Crusader with two fouls. And speaking of that, here comes Reese, Olagola, and Bantok back in for the Crusaders.
And it looks like they're going to take the chance with Olagola guarding Merrick.
And Ben Levy into the game for the Crusaders in his first minutes of the night. Hepner on the wing looking inside for O'Brien. Back to Hepner inside.
He's got to be really careful.
Again, Merrick miss inside it. With his own rebound. Tipped over to Cruz Dumont. Back to Lum Tong. Good ball movement by the Irish. Right back inside, Merrick.
Good help down.
Steal by the Crusaders. Several players on the floor. Michael Reese coming back the other way. Spin move, turns it over to Cruz Dumont. And he's coming right back coast to coast. Stolen. Tipped by Olagola out of bounds. 26 seconds on the shot clock for the Irish. I expect the Irish to look right inside to Merrick here.
Yep. It's a simple, he do that or he's going to... Get a shooter into the corner.
There's Cruz Dumont. Oh, sorry, Lum Tong. Right
nice
on cue.
Little,
nice short.
Little, screen the screener play to get the shooter in the corner. Merrick looking for a sub, I think. Sending the signal to the bench.
Olagola in traffic. Over to Padilla in the corner. Greasy inside. Cross-court pass. Bantog for three. Count it. And the Irish coming right back to Merrick. Olagola, no call.
Oh, man, that's a tough no call for both teams.
And Merrick looks hurt on the baseline. He's getting up, though. And Levy in and out. Ball tipped out of bounds by the Irish. And we'll stay here. So Holy Cross ball. We got 5:15 remaining in the half.
Merrick gives a signal to the bench. He's okay.
That's good. It looked bad for a minute. He went down pretty hard, but glad to see he's all right. 2-point lead for the Irish. Olagola looks to drive. Spin move. Layup. Good D by Merrick. Right back to Cruz Dumont.
Oh, it looks like Olagola's is hurt back here. Looks like an ankle maybe.
Kelly O'Brien rattles in for two. Olagola hobbling, but he looks like he wants to stay in the game. Oh, no, he's calling for a sub. Bantog guarded by O'Brien. Ball screen Reese. He rolls. Great pass inside. Draws the foul. A number of subs coming in for the Irish. Oh, just two. Sahil Sandhu and Jason Soriano.
And Maganon in here for Olagola.
Weak side pass by Ben Levy inside to Manganon. tipped out of bounds by Chow White. Sorry, by Toriano. Lobbed into Reese. Up top to Padilla. Pump fakes once, twice. No good. Rebounded by Sandu.
Padilla wanted a better pass on that. When you're coming off that screen, you want to get it hit right in your hands for that three. Ben Levy working really hard down there against Merrick.
Great steal by Padilla. No one to beat. And he converts the layup. 24-22. 4:20 to go. Here's Jamont. Bantok attempts the trap. Over to Sahil Sandu. He'll lay in the floater.
Just seeing two teams work their butts off right now at both ends of the floor.
It's definitely back and forth. Padilla, pump fakes, drives, kickball.
Oh, nope. Looks like we got a foul call. That was a block on Merrick. It's his first personal.
Coach Scrub asking Merrick to force him left, force Padilla left. Reese will inbound. Contact there, no call. Padilla gets his own rebound. Ball's tip. Levy saves it. Unfortunately, it goes right to Heppner. Heppner looks inside as Sandu and finishes easily over top of Mangonin. Coach Presente of Holy Cross asking for a timeout. And nice little run there by the Irish.
Coach Presente calling that timeout, wants to end this run really quickly.
A lot of controlled chaos happening right now.
Absolutely.
For both teams. A lot of in the midcourt.
This is one of those things where it's a hard game to ref. There's so much contact, so much physical play these guys
have.
Yeah,
you gotta kinda call everything or call nothing, but you can't mix it up.
Can't find an in between. And know that this is like, when are you making sure that there's actually an advantage when those contacts happen? Maybe guys, they're just gonna muscle each other, they're gonna work each other a little bit. Let some of that stuff go and let them decide what's going on, and then when there's an advantage gained, we call that foul.
Yeah, I have to say I much prefer them to let them play, let the boys figure it out on the floor rather than over ref, and they're doing a good job so far.
Yeah, good control in the game so far.
So off the Crusaders, ball coming in on their own baseline. Irish picking up full court. Padilla driving through the paint. Terrian's there to disrupt the shot, but it bounces right out of bounds. And it will be Irish ball. And Hunter Cruz Dumont.
That's just an unforced error. Not a ton of pressure there. Just needs to make a simple overhead pass, get it across, and break that press. That's what pressuring does to you. It gets in your head a little bit.
Cruz calls for a ball screen from Mangonin. Drives left. Terrian switches. And he finishes over top with the help.
Strong left-handed finish.
And Cruz Dumont called for the travel. So that's two turnovers by Cruz Dumont in the last minute. Feeling the pressure a little bit.
Just looking at the roster, these teams both loaded with grade 11s. Both teams, I think, only have three or four grade 12s on their team.
Baseline drive, Padilla. No good, gets his own rebound. Terrian with the block. He's called for the foul.
Here comes the next set of kids out here for college.
So Michael Chong and Logan Hale in for the Irish as Padilla shoots two. Michael Chong.
this is the first.
Three-point game here. Cruz Dumont crosses over center, and he's fouled by Fujimura. Coach Pesente not happy with the call. So we've got a three-point game in the 2019 BC Catholic Basketball Championship Final here. Vancouver College up 28-25 over the Holy Cross Crusaders. Michael Chong looks inside to Sandu.
Miscommunication, passer saw the back door, cutter saw the other way.
Kelly O'Brien returns the game for the Irish. Reese rips the ball through against Logan Hales. Defensive pressure here, rejects the ball screen. Corner for Bantog, he drives baseline, back out to Reese. He'll take the three, no good, rebounded by Terrian. Tight defense by Bantog on Cruz Dumont. He gets into the paint. And Bantog called for the foul. So we're in the bonus, and the Irish should be. Oh, no. That's still only four personal fouls.
Yep.
Four
both
team
teams
fouls,
four right
sorry.
Now.
So. Lobbed into Terrian.
Shooter back in the corner, I'm guessing. They're going to screen down. There it is. So many teams run that play.
Pull up jumper. Cruz Dumont. No good. Rebounded Reese. Good cut by Padilla into the paint. Puts up the floater. No good. Rebounded by Hale.
I'm impressed. Padilla able to get over those, up over those shot blocker.
Terry looking to seal inside. Swings it over to Hunter Cruz Dumont for three. Good. 6-point lead for the Irish.
Crusaders really need an answer right now. Minute 20 left to go here in the quarter.
Good cut, Padilla. He's got defense collapsed on him. Fader swing it back over to Reese. Floater in the paint. No good.
Out of bounds
on the Irish. Unlucky for the Irish there.
Strong take to the rim by Reese there.
So we've got a minute to go. Crusaders with the ball under the Irish basket. Over to Bantog. Crossover. There's Terrian. On help side, Padilla. Floater. And we've got a foul.
Going to line for two. They got Logan Hale on that one.
So that's the fifth foul for the Irish. Fifth team foul for the quarter. Padilla will shoot two. Two from the line for Padilla.
Cuts the lead down to five.
Oh,
steal by Fujimura.
And
he's going to go to the line.
The foul.
So the last foul's on Cruz Dumont. His second personal. Sends Fujimura to the line for two.
And Hebner checks back in for the Irish, and Reese San Juan will give Michael Reese a rest.
Going to make sure they get Reese off the floor for this last minute, make sure he doesn't get that last foul. It's only a four-point game. Lots of basketball left.
Fujimura misses the first. Second. Oh, no basket. Violation.
Shooter violation. Cross the line early.
So we've got a four-point game here. Irish leading 31-27. Michael Chong brings the ball up the floor, guarded by Bantog. Here comes the trap from Fujimura. Over to Heppner. Right inside to Hale. Sorry, Tarion.
Out of bounds, and Crusader ball.
40 seconds to go. And Van College picks up full court. Man to man. Bantog drives the lane. Tarion comes in help. And unclear the call.
I think we got Crusader ball on the block. I think on the block. Tejada in.
Tejada checks back in.
For San Juan, shooter on the floor for right now.
So 16 seconds on the shot clock, 26 seconds on the game clock. Padilla for three, hand in his face. No good. Rebounded Heppner.
Got 18 seconds left. Irish looking to push. Deflected out of bounds. Irish ball on the sideline.
And Van College will take a timeout for the last 14 and a half seconds to go here. Up four. I'm going to guess that Van College draws up a play to get the ball right inside on
the
steal.
Absolutely. I'd probably get something where they're going to try and isolate down on the block, get everybody else up above, get it down low.
Coach Scrub giving Michael Chong some extra pointers here. As Coach Margetti talks to the boys in the timeout. Why
do you need the same chat? Coach Scrub, done a really good job with the Vancouver College program over the last years, keeping it up near the top of the rankings every year. Of course, also his list past year, the Canadian national team qualifying for the World Championships, a big contribution.
And welcome back to the final game of the 2019 BC Catholic Basketball Championships between the number one ranked Holy Cross Crusaders and the number five ranked Vancouver College Fighting Irish. Irish lead 31-29 as we start the second half.
Irish ball coming back in. Coming back for the second half, Kevin Wallsmith, Lance Herchabees. Hope it's a fun half. Again, just want to get the ball into that middle. Mike Reese working his get his feet around, keeping his hands up.
Cruz Dumont, no good. Rebounded by Merrick over top of Reese. He's looking for the call. And pulled to the ground by Anim. Things getting physical, but it's expected. Coach Pazente asking about the over-the-back rebound by Merrick over Reese's back.
And they call that foul on Reese.
Foul on number 10.
Oh, sorry.
Interesting, he wasn't even in the play, so that must be a mistake. Some confusion happening here. Coach Scrub asking if they're getting a timeout here because of the delay. And hopefully they clear things up, but looks like they're not. So they're gonna, foul will be called on Olagola. So, okay, well, he's got three. And Tony Merrick shooting two from the line.
A lot of confusion on that play. The ref's good, at least they stopped, talked to each other. Try and get it figured out. So three on Uwe, although he doesn't still hasn't figured out what he did on that one.
Rebounded by Olagola. Coast to coast. He'll lay it up and count the bucket, making good on that somewhat of a phantom foul call there. Taking matters into his own hands.
Maybe a little bit of makeup, but I know one thing about Uwe, he's a good enough athlete that if he gets a little bit upset, he can steam down there and get going.
I'm sure the Crusaders are almost hoping that he gets angry about something. So the foul call was on Merrick, his second personal. One-point game. Irish leading 32-31. Merrick over
nice
to
Hepburn ball
in the
movement.
Corner. No good. Tipped out of bounds by the
off Irish. Coming back to the Crusaders. Good movement to get a nice shot. Hepner can't hit it down.
Padilla up top. Looking for the handoff to Reese. He's double teamed. Back over to Padilla. Baseline drive. Helps
nice
there.
Step through. Good
great
jump.
Move. Padilla.
Merrick being really disciplined there, getting his hands up.
And Anna will be called for a foul here. I believe that's his third. Yeah, so that's his third personal on Anim. So Olagola and Anim, two Crusader starters in a bit of foul trouble here early in the second half. 6:54 to go. Crusaders up one, 33-32. Chow White into Merrick, and he lays it in easily for two.
Olagola and Reese kind of have to get out of the way on that one.
And Crusaders right back, Mangonin. Great pass.
Back and forth. Here we go. This is going to be the fun half we wanted.
O'Brien over to Hepner. Chow White thinks about it. Drives in the lane. Floater. Reese attempts to take a charge. No call. Gets his own rebound. Over to Hepner again in the corner. Right back to Merrick. Cross-court pass tips.
O'Brien down low. Three in the key call. Coach Scrub just begging for a call down there in the contact.
Three in the key, the call. Looked like it was a bit of a loose ball there, but unfortunate call for the Irish. 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Reese with the ball. Hand off to Olagola. Great screen by Mangonin. Into the corner to Padilla. Pump fakes. Drives middle. No good. Rebounded Olagola. Right back up. No good. Again, no good.
Can't get it
Merrick
to go.
Coming back the other way over to Cruz Dumont. Reese challenges the shot.
Good job of Reese to keep standing up straight, keep his hands above the cylinder to prevent getting the foul there.
So it'll be VC ball coming in onto the Crusaders basket. Cross screen for O'Brien. Lob into Merrick.
It down to Merrick.
Started by Padilla, yeah, and he'll be called.
Padilla's, they're going to get him for bringing his hand down on that one. He's frustrated. He's doing everything he can. Isn't much he can do.
So Merrick, the leading scorer in the first half with 7 points. Starting things off here for the Irish. Getting to the line twice in the first couple of minutes. Merrick looks like he's bleeding from the ear a little bit. Maybe just a scratch. Makes the first. Tie game. Short on the first. Rebounded by Callum Chow White.
Gonna look for a high low here.
Up. No,
nice
not
seal.
There. Over to Cruz Dumont. Pump fakes, drives baseline. Jumper, no good. Tipped, rebounded. Cruz Dumont. Stolen. Loose ball.
Irish ball. Again, look for some. They'll probably run screens all over the place. But in the point, trying to get Merrick the ball back going to the rim right there.
And called for the hold.
Reese's getting called for the hold on the way to the rim.
So that's Reese's third now. So Olagola, Annan, Reese all with 3 fouls, working hard on D. And Coach Presente asking to watch the elbows by Merrick. And ball's inbounded to Chow White for 3. No good. Rebounded, Mangonin. And stolen by Cruz Dumont. He'll take the 3 short. Rebounded, Callum Chow White. Great job by Chow White, crashing the glass.
Crusaders flustered right now. They got a bunch of guys with 3 fouls on the floor, getting frustrated at some calls. Irish doing a good job to take advantage. Crash the glass. Try and see if they can put a run together to stretch this out. The foul now here on Irish. That's 3 on Chow White.
Speaking of runs, I don't think we've seen a run by either team. It's been tight the whole way.
Back and forth the whole way.
Villa gets the screen. Inside, blocked by Merrick. Kelly O'Brien
good
attempts
hustle
to save it, but it'll be out of bounds.
So it's fun. These guys play each other so much. There's so much on the line in every game these play. The intensity level goes through the roof.
Olagola driving on Cruz Dumont. Finger roll. Good. Cruz Dumont facing pressure. Out of bounds on the Crusaders.
Well, Tracy calling something out here. I think we might be switching to a zone.
Lumptong, no good. Ball's on the floor.
Scramble.
Several players jumping on it. And getting tangled up a bit here. And things getting a bit rough. As Merrick falls to the floor and the referee asks them to calm down a little bit.
Yes.
No love lost. No love lost between these two squads.
When you're playing each other 3-4 times a year, every year. Physical game.
Things get heated. Speaking of heat,
it is warm in here.
A little pathetic fallacy there for you English buffs.
Oh, to be working with an English teacher.
Mopping up the sweat off the floor. Good job, Coach DeGo, football coach here at Holy Cross. A man of many talents.
Absolutely. He can teach, he can coach, he can sweep.
Ball's inbounded to Anim. Flips it over to Ogola. We'll reset the offense. Call a play here. He gets into the lane. Misses the layup. Out of bounds.
Fujimura coming in for Padilla. Trying to get, I think Coach Pazente wants to get Padilla a breather before one of these other guys gets their third foul. Or fourth foul, when he's going to have to come in.
Merrick over to Heppner. Long two, no good. Rebounded by Risi. He's coming back the other way. Looks for the dish. Mangonin's there. Draws the foul.
Nice patience there by Risi with a good jump stop. Basic fundamentals. Look for someone, find him, cut into the hoop, draw a foul.
Foul's called on Michael Chong. That's his second. Shooting two, Andre Mangonin.
Free throws are going to be really big in this second half as guys get fouls. This tight a game, that might be the difference in the game.
Everything matters. Turnovers, rebounds.
Two for two. As a coach, that's what you ask for every single time when we get the line. Can we go two for two?
Olagola is looking all right with his injury in the first half.
Yep,
doesn't seem to be bothering him.
No problem getting to the rim and getting up.
Josh Lumtong over to Kelly O'Brien.
Crusaders now switching it up in kind of a softer 1-2-2 half zone. Oh, Fujimura got caught.
Pretty easy. Overeager there.
It's the easy call. Now he's going to line. They got almost 4 minutes where they're in the bonus here. The Irish will be shooting two on every foul.
He converts on the first. Josh Lumtong with the chance to tie it up here. No good. Tipped by Terrien. Olagola gets out of the corner. Drives middle over to Fujimura. He'll shoot. Short. Tipped out by Terrien. We'll stay here.
Thought we were going to see something. Maybe Olagola coming down and down, going right up to the rim there. Unselfish play.
Balls inbounded to Olagola. Looks inside to Fujimura.
Nice cut by Fujimura. They're running that elevator screen to try and get Risi to the three. Overplay by College to get the back door. Good discipline here by the Crusaders.
Hand off to Fujimura. Drives middle. Bobbles it over to Mangonin. And he'll go back to the line.
They like that handoff, then either a ball screen or an attack. Find someone to come help on the ball and then see if you can get someone going to the rim.
Three 14 to go here in the third quarter. Crusaders up 40-38.
Another two for two for Mangonin.
Great job by Mangonin to convert on those free throws. Sahil Sandhu checks in. Kelly O'Brien will have a seat.
Kyle Tejada in for the Crusaders for Mangonin. So Crusaders in again in that kind of half-court trap. 1-2-2. Just maybe slow guys down instead of necessarily trying to get turnovers.
Broken in the middle by Heppner. Over to Lumtong. No good. Rebounded Chow White. He's double-teamed. Right back inside to Sandhu. Good.
Nice shot.
Fujimura blocked by Terry.
Going to be goaltending. The ball is on the...
The question is, did it hit the backboard?
I think it hit the backboard already. Yeah. He took it off. It wasn't above the rim yet, but if it hits the backboard, you can't touch that ball. Once it's on top of the rim, then you can knock it down.
So we'll count the bucket. Crusaders up 43-40, 2:50 to go in the third. Referee's asking to reset the shot clock.
In the boys' side in BC, we go 30-second with a 10-second backcourt. The girls, if you were watching earlier, are 24-8.
Some talk about going to a 24-second shot clock for boys.
Love to see that.
As Sandhu misses. Rebounded by Fujimura. Kapner slips up. fans enjoyed that. Anim, great pass to Reese, baseline drive. Great finish with Darian.
Excellent, using that reverse layup to protect the ball from the shot blocker. He can only go up so high.
Irish having a little trouble with the pressure. They've got to get it over center. Stolen by Olagola to Anim. He lays it up, no good. Facing pressure from Sandu. Another turnover, and this time he's good. T. Anim. No quit.
Timeout, BC.
And the Crusaders on the floor, pumped up. Feeling like they got a good handle on this game right now.
And here's where this tournament, being the home team, being the host team, really comes into play. The crowd is into it. They're excited. If you're watching, you can see they're all up on their feet in the middle of the floor. Vancouver College fans on the left side.
A little more subdued.
A little more right now. I'm sure they'll be on their feet when this gets going down the stretch.
So the tension is building here in the third quarter. Crusaders up by 7. It's been tight the whole game. I think this is probably the biggest lead we've had in this game.
Yeah, I think in the first half we saw the biggest lead at 5 or 6 from Vancouver.
7-0. You're right. 7-0 to start the game. Oh, sorry. 7-2 to start the game off for the Irish. It was the first quarter, it was 18-17 for the Irish.
Irish had a 6-point lead at their highest.
So this is the biggest lead.
Biggest lead of the game.
So 2:06 to go in the third quarter.
And this is one of those things why Holy Cross likes to use that pressure. You can really put runs together really quick. You can turn a team over 2 times in a row and get some layups. It's frustrating, it's hard, and you can get some easy looks. Don't have to work so hard. Shot blockers aren't in the paint.
And it really relies on buy-in from the players.
Absolutely.
And trust the process.
Ton of hard work. Oh, Crusaders get caught.
Weak
on the back
side. Logan Hales there. Merrick rebound. Good.
Up. Good vision. I think that was Cruz Dumont to see that skip pass.
Bantog over to Reese. Back to Bantog. Padilla inside. Turns around. Some footwork there, I think.
Yep, got a hop on the same foot when he was trying to do that split.
So the new FIBA rules have taken effect with traveling and steps, and not sure everybody quite has a handle on it.
I don't have a handle on it. I've just told the refs they're in charge. They figure it out. If they call a travel, I'll deal with it. But I think that one was pretty obvious that he went skip from one step to the same foot.
Yeah. Sandu guarded by Olagola.
You know, all those new rules, your pivot foot still got to be your pivot foot.
Right inside to Merrick, double teamed by Olagola and Reese. Bobble gets it back, Cruz Dumont, pump fake, elbow jumper, no good. Rebounded by Reese. Coach Scrub asking his players to get up tighter on the Crusaders. Olagola drives and he's fouled.
Catches him in the block, hit the ground hard, both guys. See some good sportsmanship there by Merrick helping him up. It's nice to see in a heated game where guys can still help each other out there.
So Olagola able to shake it off. He's taking his bumps this game, but he's no worse for wear.
So that's third foul on Merrick.
Tarion checks in for him.
Nice problem to have when you can just roll the next kid out there.
Our big has 3 fouls. Let's put in a bigger guy.
The Crusaders come with their biggest guy at 6'4", 3,
on a good day.
On a good day when his hair's bigger. TJ Fujimura back into the game for Tejada. Coach Scrub wants his team together there while they had some time.
Olagola short on the first. I'd like to see these free throws matter, but I think everything matters at this point.
Absolutely. It's just those easy ones where you go, there's nobody guarding me. I want to make that shot while I can.
And
0 for 2.
It's a tough one. Cruz Dumont.
Especially when it starts center, that break.
Going straight at Reese.
Offensive foul. It's a gutsy call by Reese to step in when he knows he's got fouls. Gets there early.
Oh, So Michael Reese, last year's BC Catholics Defensive Player of the Year, also given recognition for guarding Diego Mafia last week at the Legal Beagle Tournament. So,
yep, he's a kid who just doesn't care. Whatever it takes, I'll work hard. And then this today had to start off, and he's guarding Merrick. He'll do whatever it takes. That's what all these kids are willing to do.
Greasy drives left, skip pass into the corner to Fujimura. Right back over to the other side to Bantog for three. Shorts. Terry in with the rebound. Guarded by Reese. Double teamed. Gets it over to Sean Heppner.
Good recognition by Padilla there. Irish had them beat. He took the two hard steps. Similar to like you teach in hockey. When you're going down the middle of the floor, just put your head down and sprint. Make something happen.
Don't get caught in the trolley tracks.
That's right.
30 seconds to go here. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Bantog with the ball. Ball screen from Manganin. Over to Reese. Corner three. Padilla short. Rebounded Fujimura. Weak side. Can't convert. Ball is bobbled around. Fujimura comes up with it.
12 seconds left. Good hustle play there by the Crusaders to get it back.
Padilla in the lane right at Tyrion.
Good. Tyrion did a good job there just jumping straight up.
One. Bantog. No quit in these Crusaders.
Gutsy play. Get the pump fake from the grade 12.
So a huge momentum booster going into the fourth quarter with Holy Cross leading by eight. Now the biggest lead of the game.
That 5-8 is a big difference, especially in this 8-minute quarters.
This is the game.
Yeah.
This sold out fan base is getting their money's worth for this one. All right, so 50-42 lead, Holy Cross leading Vancouver College in the 2019 BC Catholic basketball final game.
What?
Hoping to repeat their victory over Vancouver College from last year and their third win of the year over the Fighting Irish. Van College hoping to fight back here and make a game of it.
And we're back. Same lineup coming in for the Crusaders. Irish coming back with their starting five. Chow White's been out with fouls, so he's going to be nice and fresh.
O'Brien inside to Merrick. Their bread and butter. Right back out to O'Brien. He'll shoot the three. Shorts.
Going to start the break for the Crusaders.
Gola with one man to beat.
Oh.
Bobbles it.
Nice.
Covered by Merrick, but hustle he play. Also bobbles it out of bounds.
It was a nice hustle play by Chow White to get in there, cut him off, and force him to make that almost turnover.
Players looking a little bit tired, but still fighting. Gola over to Fujimura. Trap the 2-3 zone here by the Irish. 5 seconds on the shot clock. 4-3. Reese drives. Left-hand layup. No good. Rebound to Padilla.
Wow.
Put back. 10-point lead for the Crusaders.
Pressed by these Crusaders guards hitting the glass against these guys. Again, that skip pass is there.
Cruz Dumont guarded by Padilla a little too tightly. He'll be called for the foul. And him returns to the game. And that's Brent Padilla's third personal to join the other slew of Crusaders with three fouls.
Bantog getting a hand as he comes off the floor. Gave him some big minutes there with that big shot to finish the quarter.
Chow White. Merrick looking to seal inside. He falls to the floor.
Reese and Merrick is just right a really fun battle to watch on the block.
Oh, and yep. Cruz Dumont takes an elbow to the face. And the call is...
So we had Padilla, the elbow to the face, the Cruz Dumont right to the nose.
And Cruz Dumont bleeding quite a bit here as he'll get medical attention. So referee's figuring out how they're going to call this. A lot of physicality on that play between the post seal and rebound. And they're going to call in a sportsmanlike foul on Brent Padilla. So that means that Vancouver College will get two shots and the ball.
And I think Padilla, is that his third or his fourth?
That's his fourth.
So he just picked up two in a row really quick there. It's a tough one for them to deal with.
May give Vancouver College an opportunity here.
But 10-point lead. Holy Cross can afford this for a couple minutes. Get him a quick break. Get him back in a sec. So it'll be Chong to the line for the free throws.
So this would be big for the Irish as Sean goes 2 for 2 from the line to bring it back into an 8-point lead for the Crusaders. And they'll get the ball back. So a potential 4 to 5-point swing here if they were to hit a 3.
Maganon back into the game for Fujimura. Fun just watching Merrick and Reese battle a little bit. These guys have probably been playing against each other since they're in grade 12 now, since they're in elementary school.
Good move by Heppner.
So there's that 4-point swing you were talking about. Just cut it to 6.
Six minutes to go.
Vancouver College in the zone. Trying to take away that dribble penetration from the Crusaders.
Corner 3, Reese. Good! Makes up for the 4-point swing that they just lost there. Stretches it back up to 9 points. Chow White, double teamed. Foul on Reese. So that'll be Reese's fourth.
So now we have Padilla with 4, Reese with 4, 5 minutes 45.
Olagola with 3, and him with 3. Nobody for Vancouver College really in much foul trouble.
I think it was Chow White was the only one with 3.
With 3, yeah.
He got his rest in the third quarter. America, I think, only has 1 or 2.
Heppner for 3. No good. O'Brien tips it out of bounds.
Good hustle play, but back to the Crusaders. Reese getting a break right now, too.
Penn College in a zone.
So now they want to give him some space.
Looks like a 2-3.
So 1-3-1, I think.
A lot of pressure on the high post. 1-3-1.
1-3-1. Right. Now they're dropping maybe to a 2-3 a little bit.
Tejada wide open. 3, a bit long. Tipped to Anim.
Great hustle play by Maganon to get it there.
Skip pass. Baseline drive. Tejada looking for an outlet.
Good.
Stolen by Merrick.
Good job by Merrick to step out of his zone.
Great outlet pass to Chow White.
Good
out
play.
Great
step.
Great take by Callum Chow White. And a great outlet pass from
Merrick. Absolutely. Hit that ahead. Strong move, takes two big long steps. He's allowed, takes the foul from Anim, who's that's his fourth, I think, now too.
And Holy Cross asking for a timeout to
stop this run.
Stop this run and clear their heads.
Really important, I think, probably to also get a game plan on what they're doing against that zone and what they're going to do with that with the personnel that they've got on the floor with the foul trouble that they're dealing with.
Yeah, it looks like a 2-3 zone where the big man in the middle comes up to guard the high post.
Yep. And they're doing a good job. Those guys are collapsing down into the paint when he steps up. That's why they're getting that open corner that Reese just hit. Mm-hmm. Kyle Tejada, the grade 11, maybe not used to that kind of spotlight. And did knock that one down, but kids have all been here before. Junior level.
Tejada really known as a perimeter shooter.
Absolutely.
And hoping to get things going this year. So far, he's been a little bit hot and cold, but as of late, it's been hitting some big shots for them.
All right, referee's calling out at the timeout. Coach Pazente trying to work the referees a little bit there, pointing out on the board it's 4-0 for the Crusaders. I don't think there's any Crusader fouls that haven't been fouls. Just hoping to get his guys some, get a benefit of a call here and there.
Chow White converts the and one. 6-point lead. Getting down to the wire here. Under 5 minutes left in the game. Oladola off the sideline over to Tejada.
Still in that 2-3 zone. See what Crusaders do. Probably going to get Oladola and Maganon into the post a little bit. Nice seal by Maganon.
Great pass, Oladola. Tejada with the finish. 57-49. Right inside to Merrick. And good hands by the big man to finish the layup.
I would love to be have a guy like that when I played. You just kind of throw it up. Here's my assist.
Yeah.
No, and he's going to go get it.
Tejada inside versus Merrick. Great defense. Turnover Crusaders.
I'm really impressed at how disciplined Merrick is when he gets down there on the block. Just get his hands up and knows he can challenge that shot without having to jump.
And Merrick called
travel
for the travel.
Called. He's going to be frustrated with that one.
Cruz Dumont looks like he's doing much better.
We get Hebner and out of the game.
Josh Lumtong in for the Irish.
So the Irish in their press now again. And they're going to get Child White with this fourth.
A little bit of gamesmanship there from Hannum and Chow White.
Yeah, absolutely. Both guys kind of want to make the other guy see if we can get that foul there or we're getting up.
And you know after the game they'll be buddies.
I don't know. This rivalry goes pretty deep. Some of these guys do play together, they nail each other, but it is nice to see, though, teenagers sometimes. It's just, yep, let's get off the court. Let's we can do things after that.
Yep. Great job by the grade 8 volunteer to sweep up the sweat.
Not a fun job.
Tipped by Cruz Dumont.
Staked by the young grade 11.
Great spin move. Short on the finish. Rebounded by Michael Reese. Coach Scrub calling for an elbow by Reese on the rebound there.
I don't think he's going to get that one. He's got his hands, arms tight to the ball. He's pivoting. He's allowed to move the basketball.
Corner three, Fujimura.
Oh, knocks it down. Big stuff for that last turnover. Big shot by the grade 11.
Big shot, TJ. And Manganin called for the hold on Merrick. That's his third, I believe. And we're in the bonus, so he'll shoot two on that with the clock stopped. Oh, correction. It's Manganin's second foul. And And Irish continue to make their free throws, which have kept us in this, kept them in this game for sure. So 2 for 2 for Merrick.
7-point game, 3 minutes. Fouls are 5-1. Both teams with 2 timeouts.
And double teams. Drives baseline all the way through. And
nice smart play by Anum. Just avoid that double team. Just keep going through.
Yep. Greasy screen. Over to Olagola. He attacks. Hop, skip, and a jump.
Oh! And unlucky. That's out. A nice play.
And rims out. Unfortunate there for Olagola.
Again, similar to Chow White before. Those really long, great steps. Those kids are working on their footwork. Be able to get around those standing defenders.
O'Brien looks for the high-low. It's not there. Great defense by Reese. And Cruz Dumont goes down hard.
Yep.
It's going to be icing up tomorrow. And if I will
it's
be going to
be the fifth on T.
So that'll be Anim's fifth and disqualifying foul. Cruz Dumont misses the first.
Vancouver College assistants coming out, just giving
Coach
a hand.
Beers doing the handiwork down there, cleaning up the mess.
That's a great shot.
So he goes 0 for 2 from the line.
Vancouver College still staying out in that extended zone.
Skip pass over to Bantar. Drives baseline, sinks again. Reverses it back over to Padilla. Right back to the corner, he'll shoot. No good.
Irish are off.
The floor passes backwards. Questionable backcourt violation.
He had lots of space. He's just got long legs.
Ball screen, Kelly O'Brien for Chow White. Chow White with pressure, and he'll get the foul.
Another one on Manganon. Crusaders probably won't mind that. Was that on double zero?
It was on double zero.
Sorry.
I think he said 2-0.
I thought he said 2-0.
Yeah, he said 2-0s. Yeah.
I don't know what Mr. Presente's doing, letting these guys have a double zero and a zero on the floor. Referee's got enough things I got to deal with.
Callum Chow-White at the line. Down 7, hits the first. Minute 53 to go.
Going right down to the wire. We already saw one game go to overtime in the third, fourth game.
Yeah, well, we have the second one here. Coach Scrub using Coach K's term. Next play, don't worry about it, guys. Didn't get the call on that one. Shaders get it over half. Into the corner to Bantar.
The zone's doing a really good job for Vancouver College.
A lot of pressure from Cruz Dumont. Skip pass over to Olagola. Looks inside to Reese.
Nice high-low pass, drawing Merrick up.
Great play.
He stepped around Merrick 3 times in a row. That time he's going to just pull up. Got Reese the little easy one. 8-point game.
Deep three.
Deep three.
Chow White. Nope. Olagola back on the floor. He'll pull out. Try to use a bit of the clock here. And Coach Scrub asking for a timeout. Next opportunity.
I think Coach Presente's already called for one.
Timeout's in high demand.
So it'll be
Olagola into the lane. Floater. No good.
just depends who scores.
And we'll stay here. So. And Van College will take a timeout. And so a coach from Vancouver College over the scorer's table questioning whether or not Holy Cross called the timeout first.
He did. He said it was on a score.
He said he didn't want the timeout anymore, and then Coach Grubb called a timeout. So a little bit of confusion, but the timeout will be charged to Vancouver College. So we got just over a minute to go here. 8-point lead for the Crusaders. And Crusaders hoping to hang on here for their fourth consecutive BC Catholic Championship over the Vancouver College Fighting Irish.
It's hanging on is all they're doing right now. There's still a lot of time left. They still have a bunch of guys with some foul issues.
Really a three-possession game right now. This could go change in a hurry, so... Shaders can't get ahead of themselves or ease up and let their foot off the gas pedal. Great screen and roll by O'Brien. Get it inside.
Got by Reese to leave it, recognize. Nice long stride again. Chow White
Loader,
into the rim.
Chow White. And now the Shaders will take their timeout. So now it's cut to six with 41 seconds to go. Crusaders will get the ball. This is the new FIBA rule as well. They get to choose where they want it on their own baseline with 30 seconds on the shot clock, or whether they want to have the ball in the front court with 18 seconds left.
So, Coach Wellsmith, what do you think we've got getting drawn up over there by Coach Pazente?
Well, assuming that he's asking for the ball in the front court, I'm going to guess that they're going to run Ola Gola off a screen or to their best free throw shooter, maybe.
Probably.
To the line.
Maybe I didn't probably see something like Reese inbound the ball, maybe get it right back to him.
Irish will probably go. Deny hard, try and get a steal here. If not, they may have to start fouling. They've only got one foul, so they'll have to foul quite a bit if they'd like to stop the clock. And Heppner does just that. So still got to do three more now. Again, probably looking to deny inbounds to get a steal. If not, foul.
They've got a lot of fouls to give, so they're going to do this quick.
Force it back down with Tom.
So we'll get Ola Gola inbounding the ball. Probably going to try and get it. It's going to go to into Padilla.
Ball's inbounded. Padilla will be fouled by Merrick. So I believe it's his fourth. Yeah, his fourth. So he won't want to make the next foul. Irish still need two more to put the Crusaders on the line. Ball goes in to Reese, fouled by nobody. He's over to Padilla. I guess they're looking not to foul Reese. And they'll get a jump ball call.
Wow.
So it's going back to the
interesting
Crusaders,
call there. Those guys kind of intentionally going, trying to get that foul, reaching around. Referee giving him the free held ball. Don't see that very often.
Donner DeRisi, and he'll dribble right through the lane. Kick it over to Bantog. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Five. And foul.
Now they'll get the foul.
Now the foul is on Cruz Dumont. Still one more foul to give here.
Coach Scrub a little frustrated. They didn't seem like there was contact right off the bat and bounds.
I thought there would be a foul.
Especially, most referees know that's the situation. It's like they're going to put a hand on. We want to avoid kind of too hard a foul to get someone hurt.
Right.
Make that call for that team. Yeah.
I guess I'd be careful about not intentionally fouling with an emphasis on that by the FIBA rules this year.
Yep.
So Bantog will go to the line. 20.5 seconds to go here for...
Still only a 6-point game.
Two possessions. These are big free throws.
Oof.
And he missed the first, so... Still a chance for the Irish.
Second, as Vancouver College asked for a timeout. So
20.5 seconds to go. Vancouver College down 7. So crazier things have happened.
Yep. Right now, I mean, it's can you get either a really, really quick basket to turn, then try and turn them over and foul again? Or do you come down and try to get that hero shot to start? Can I get that three? Get it in bounds, kick it out.
I'm assuming they'll take whatever is
yeah,
given to them.
Absolutely.
First good look, and then try to steal or foul.
Maybe try and pump fake, see if the Crusaders will play on discipline.
It'd be great to get 3 points, three free throws with the clock stopped.
Yeah. Feel like
maybe James Harden would know how to do that.
Mr. Vicente, probably, and Mr. Shasser over there, going to tell these guys, make sure you're up, no need to foul. Even if they make the shot, just challenge it, so no jumping.
Yep, players have to be very disciplined here in these crunch time minutes.
The table, else gonna bitch about it.
What's she complaining about? I don't fuck with her.
Was the, did you turn the, this mic off?
All right, here we go. 20.5 seconds to go. And the referee explaining that there's blood on the floor that needs to be cleaned up.
Spray bottle.
Yeah, we need spray bottles to get the blood off the court.
Literally blood, sweat, and tears here for the final game.
So, Holy Cross now, looks like they're coming out in a 2-3 zone. Just mix it up.
Deep three, Chow White. Good!
Shot.
17 and a half seconds to go.
So we talked about it. Did it quick.
Quick three.
And the Crusaders even put themselves in a tough spot. That was close.
So 4-point lead here for Holy Cross. Irish not going down easy.
Nope. So it'll be a front court foul. So a big thing that Holy Cross is going to look for here is run the play. I'm guessing they're going to probably want, it's going to be Padilla they're going to try to get the ball into. He's, I think, their best free throw shooter.
Yeah, I got the feeling that they didn't really want to foul Michael Reese. They waited until he passed the ball off to commit the foul on
yep.
one of those plays. So, but then later they did. So
I think at this point, really, Vancouver College just got to foul. They want to save clock. It doesn't matter. They got to foul first guy right away. They're going to trap and foul. But if I'm the Crusaders, I'm guessing Olagola is going to inbound. You get that strong inbounder that can make the skip pass if needed and get the ball into Padilla or to Reese right away. Notice Kyle Tejada has just come into the game.
Want a shooter on the floor here?
Foul shooter.
In case they,
although Maganot's been one of their best foul shooters this whole game.
That's true.
He also gives him a little bit of a rebounding edge here.
So Cruz Dumont, O'Brien, Chow White, Merrick, and Hepner for the Irish. Bantog, Reese, Olagola, Padilla, and Tejada for the Crusaders. Little cross-screen action into Tejada. Trapped in the corner. Gets out of trouble, and Reese's foul.
And there we get the foul. Reese trying to argue, see if he can get a call there, see if he can get the intentional foul. Get two in the ball. Ref's not going to buy that one.
Merrick asks for a sub.
It's five fouls on Merrick, I think.
And Sahil Sandhu will come in.
So they're putting in him, probably give a shooter instead of getting in Terry in there.
Reese connects on the first.
Exciting game for Reese. This kid, his dad was, of course, coach at Holy Cross for years when he was growing up. Now is a grade 12, gets to finish off his career.
Short on the second, Van College. Back the other way, looking for a quick hoop here. Chow White looks to cross over. Floater, no good. Rebounded by Reese.
That's it.
And your 2019 champions, the four-peat for the Holy Cross Crusaders.
Four tournaments in a row, the third time the charm again for BC this year. And your player of the game just given to us here will be number 10, Uyulagola.
It could have been a number of players,
absolutely,
but Uyulagola with a very strong game, battling through injury. Well done by the Crusaders. And a great game played by the Vancouver College Fighting Irish
as well. Absolutely. And I don't think this is, they've three times now. They'll probably see each other again sometime.
Sure they will down the road.
Provincials. Seems like every year they get matched up in the same bracket of provincials too.
Yeah.
So I'm sure this won't be the last they see each other this year.
Yeah. Great game by both.
And we will, I think we're going to sign off.
Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next year.
Take your table!